Okay.
I'll start out with an easy one. David Fraun's having a career year. What do you attribute it to? What has he done from training camp to now that it's improved his game, and how far more can he take it?
Yeah, no, David's a good hockey player. He's taking advantage of a lot of ice time. He's playing power play. He's probably playing about 17 minutes a night usually. And again, he's a guy that's very strong on the puck. He's got a great shot, and he's taking opportunities. So I like the way he's playing. He competes and battles hard, and he's strong on pucks.
Where do you and he connect so well?
Me and him?
Yeah.
I don't know the guy very well, but I enjoyed him from day one. You know, he comes to the rink every day, and most days he's real happy. He's a guy that wants to be on the ice all the time. He's always looking at me saying, "When am I?" You know, he's not saying, but he's always looking back, "Am I ready to go?" And I like hungry players, and he's a hungry hockey player. So he works hard, competes hard, and when you play like that, enjoy it.
And it's suffice to say, this team would not be where it is without him. He's been a very big part.
He's been a big part, yeah. He's been a big part, and he's got a lot of points, and you know, he plays hard every night. So I really enjoyed watching him play and working hard, and he wants to get better, and you know, he's enjoying it with the team winning.
Fine, I'll ask the harder question.
I know
he's
going
to toss up softballs for 5 minutes.
What, excuse me?
What's going on with Schmidt and Spezza?
Spezza's going to be out a little longer. Smith is day-to-day, but Spezza's going to be out, I don't know how long it's going to be, but he's probably going to win the IR.
Coach, we can sit up in the press rows, there's reporters watching, or on TV watching Eric Carlson and what he's capable of, and Reed, we know what he can do, but as a coach, what's fascinating for you about that type of player, him specifically, what's the fascination about
him? He's played a great two-way game for us. I mean, like I said, nobody expected him to have, what's he got, 33 goals right now?
No, Eric Carlson. What makes him do it?
Eric Carlson.
What's about him, his...
Eric Carlson's been a star in the league for how many years now? I mean, he's a Norris Trophy candidate every year. He's one of the, if not the best passing defenseman in the league. He's right up there and a very talented guy. So, no, he's a real good hockey player that comes to play every night, and he always ends up one of the top scorers in your team. And they get a lot out of
it. Speaking of Carlson, what makes him dangerous on the ice?
Which Carlson?
Eric.
Because I get them mixed up all the time, too.
Long hair. It's
So what makes Eric Carlson dangerous on the ice?
He sees the ice so good. He's a talented player. He's got a great vision. Like I said, he's one of the best passers in the game, if not the best. And sees the ice, plays a big offensive game for them, and moves the puck real good, skates real good. That's why he's a Norris Trophy winner. Every year he's one of the candidates.
Kirk, would Spezza's situation be what it is you anticipate Dino being in the lineup tomorrow?
Sorry, no.
Would Spezza's situation be what it is?
Yeah.
Would you anticipate Theodore returning?
Yeah. He'll be in the lineup.
What was this about not having him on the ice?
Theodore?
Yes.
His speed is unbelievable. He's a good hockey player for us. His offensive instincts and the way he's come a long way this year. So we really miss him, but the way he skates and moves the puck, we really miss that in the power play. So, big part of our group, and we're happy to have him.
Besides the numbers and the raw talent of what would you say is the biggest quality that he has?
His leadership is second to none. I mean, I didn't know the guy, knew enough to say hello to him. That was about it before this year. But when he comes in the room, his personality, loves coming to the rink every day. He's smiling every day, and you don't get that in a whole lot of hockey players every day, but he's consistently happy and has fun with our group, and he's like a 21-year-old kid playing his first game all over again. It's hard to say that, but that's what it seemed like with him.
On Monday, when you decided to kick early in front of the park, were you surprised? Were you laughing like that, or you said?
One of the video coaches showed us that, and we were laughing. I mean, that's him, you know, he's enjoying it all the time. Pressure moments, he enjoys it, and that's why he's been a winner his whole career, you know, but it was pretty funny.
We went a few months without hearing you talk about blue paint getting in the net. In the last few weeks, we've heard that more and more from you and players. Is it an adjustment other teams have made, or Maybe it's just the time of the year where things get tougher.
Every coach says the same. Trust me. I mean, I said that when I coached in junior hockey. You know, I mean, when you watch goals every night on TV, when you watch the highlights, so many of the goals are scored in those areas. And like I said, every team tries to keep players out of the blue paint. Every team tries to tell your forwards to get to the blue paint because that's where you're going to pay a price and that's where you're going to score your goals. And like I said, I'm no different than any coach, believe me. So it's part of your game plan for every team. And, you know, the guys that get there the most usually win those games. And like I said, the other night, you know, you watch the game back and, you know, I was disappointed. But when I watched the game back, I was a lot happier. Even though we lost, we got the more blue paints than I thought we did. We had more chances than I thought we did.
You have a status update on Neil for tomorrow. Is he...
Neil tomorrow? Questionable.
How about Lindbergh?
He's not playing tomorrow.
Coach.
Getting better.
I'm from out of town, from the Seattle Times, so excuse me for asking questions. But what's been the best part of being part of building something from the ground up like this?
It's been real special. The day I was announced to be the first coach of the expansion team, it was a big thrill for me. I mean, I had some other jobs in Florida and Columbus, but I was really excited to be part of an expansion team and to come to a new market like Vegas. And I mean, as you know, things have gone real good for us. It's been a perfect season so far. I mean, it's been a lot of fun. The excitement in our city has been unbelievable. The excitement at our game is second to none that I've ever been to. So it's been, so far, it's been perfect.
When did you realize that you had something special going on, both off the ice and on the ice?
Well, it didn't take long. I mean, We had that first two games on the road, and we won both those hockey games, so that was pretty exciting. But after our seven-game homestand after that, we knew it was pretty special. Our fans were behind us every night. The noise in the building was something special, and the atmosphere in our building was unbelievable. So I think after that nine games, we knew it was a special season.
Yeah, just one more. Do you think there's something to... all the players kind of being hungry and something to prove?
I didn't think at first, as these guys can attest to it, I didn't think it was a big deal when they played their old teams and that, and it was a chip on their shoulder, but every guy played really well against his old team, so there probably was a chip on their shoulder, and they wanted to prove people wrong, and you know, they've had a great season, all the guys are working hard, and like I said, they come out to the rink every night, and I don't think there's a chip on their shoulder anymore. I think every player that's in that locker room is real excited to be with the Vegas Golden Knights, and they're really enjoying their time.
A couple of days removed from the last game, and being able to watch the replays, do you have a different opinion on the Reeves' penalties in the third period, or the same opinion that you had that night?
I didn't have an opinion that night. I think I said there was, you know, that.
Well, you didn't like them.
Yeah, I didn't like them. Yeah. So, did you have some shame?
Yeah, I'm just asking if your opinion has changed. I thought they were 50.
Because you said I was really crucial on them. I wasn't really crucial on them. I just said I didn't like them. I wasn't really upset at it. I understood the calls. But you know, I'm not going to get into words with refereeing, but I mean, people that seen them.
Coach, you briefly touched after the game on Tatar's play. Seems like the chemistry that you talked about all season and how well they figured that his style fit really well. Anything on the ice today with practice? You like his style fitting in with your team?
No, I'm... We know what type of player he was when we traded for him. I mean, he's played in the NHL. He's a goal scorer. So we know what type of style he's going to bring to our hockey club. I like him. He's a good hockey player. He's going to fit in good with our group. But again, it's not going to happen in one or two or three games. I think, you know, six, seven games down the road, you're going to say, you know, he knows our system. He knows his style. He's going to fit in with his line mates. So I don't think it's a big adjustment period, but he's going to fit in good with our group. I got no issue with that. He's a good hockey player. He's a goal scorer. And we really like what we got.
Thanks, Coach.
Hey, guys.